So we're going to start from Brad today. Well, the partner grabs our lapel this way. So it's sort of, he clearly sees, if someone grabs you like this, it's fair to say they don't see you as a threat because they're already inside the fight zone. They've already taken hold. They're not sort of doing this and building themselves up. They're in the zone, they've got hold of you, and they're being intimidating. Perhaps topping up the last bit of confidence to be, but certainly they're confident enough to be here. So once we're in this position and they have a good grip, our technique is as our hands come up naturally, if someone comes into our space, we should already be doing what we discussed last time and bringing our hands up. But if we haven't, or if they've come in too quickly, the hand that's grabbed, the same side, that hand is going to trap here. And as I trap, I'm going to pivot, because what they're not doing is holding us like this at arm's length. It's that kind of thing. What did you say? So they're pulling us in. So as they've already got us close here, we're close enough to hit. So before the next one comes in, we're going to trap this one, we're going to turn with our hip, and we're going to elbow with our palm down. You can do palm in if that helps you, but I find pushing the palm down and twisting this way helps me. So the first part here is this, a trap and a twist. You can, as you twist your hip, pull on this to emphasize the pulling in of him to emphasize this if you need to. But this is the first part. Secondly, as you hit him and he goes back, this will want to extend because you're moving him away. So as that happens and your hip comes back out, this gap will become bigger. So what we're going to do here is change hands. And as this comes back, this may well want him to come off. But if it doesn't matter, all you're doing is pushing it away to stop it being reused here. And we're going to strike this way into the face. So again. So the first part, one, two, this way. One, two, coming over the top and underneath. So the grabs. So we're going to do six each side. The first three, you may just want to do this and see if you can feel that. See if you can mess it up in any way naturally to see if there's a way that it needs adjusting for you. One, two. Once you have this, remember, if I'm hitting the side of his head, the force is sending them this way. And if I want to continue with something this way, I quickly need to change this so he's now going that way instead of back if I'm going to follow him. So once we get to the second part where we're here and he starts to move back, what I'm going to do is, as he moves, because a gap will be created from this strike, I'm going to step and keep this out just in case. If I do come into contact because I'm faster than he is in his moving back, then I keep it there to add to the push. And once I'm there, I'm going to follow with a last backhand punch and step. Take down and throw. Don't forget, he's already been hit and he's off balance. So that sweep won't be as difficult as it'll be because you're still with your partner. So one, two, step, three, and take down. You may need to add a push in class, but if I've just done this and this, and then I step with this, he's probably already going. This and this is just a counter. But if we were to look at it really slow, from a class point of view, when he gets to here, if I just sweep, that might be enough. So it's almost like a push when I'm hitting at the same time. So you can either do three and then add